Who keeps making all these vases? All right, so I've been turning some bud vases on my wood lathe and kind of got it down to a technique I really like and thought it was pretty slick, so I wanted to share it with everyone. First thing you're gonna need is a mandrel, something that'll fit in your wood lathe. This is an MT2 taper. It's 1 inch on the outer part there, 25.4 millimeters. I made this on a mini lathe, but I think you can order these blank MT2 stubs that you can use as well. Probably accomplish the same thing. Next thing we're going to need is some blocks that are ready to go for turning. These will each have a 1 inch bore in them that the mandrel will accept. You're going to need a lot of sandpaper. I take mine from 80 grit up to 600 grit, and then finish with this walnut furniture oil here. Food safe, really nice, goes on fast. And then the last thing we're going to need is some test tubes. So I ordered some 1 inch or 25.4 millimeter test tubes, and that is going to serve as the lining for our vase. Let's cut some blanks out of this jatoba, which is extremely hard, so we'll see how this goes. Not too bad. All right, then out of this piece, I'm looking to get about a 4 inch, a 3 inch, and a 2 inch blank ready for the lathe. Let's hit a 4, 3 and a little change, 2 and a little change. We don't need to be exact. We're gonna refine this on the lathe. Find our centers. And again, not looking for a ton of precision here. Close is good enough. Ready to drill. So the trick here is we want to drill them all to the same total depth, not distance from the bottom, distance from the top, so that when we're done and we put the test tubes in, you've got a nice gradation between the height. The way I like to do that is get some tape on the drill bit, start with my smallest, mark the depth with a Sharpie. Close is good enough. Let's get drilling. Last step here is just to nip off the corners and make it a little easier to get turning once we get over to the lathe. All right, well, let's get to making these round. So we'll start with our mandrel. Get that tapped in well so it seats. Tool rest out of the way. And then let's start with the little guy here. Can definitely feel when it bottoms out and it's good to go. And then for the first part of the process, I'm going to bring in my tail support here. Just put a little tension on it, doesn't take much. And that should be ready to go. Start with a round carbide. It's a little bit high. No good. All right. If I didn't edit that out, I got another short one prepared off camera here, and let's give it a try again. Possible there was a little bit of crack in the wood, or I kind of tapped it onto the mandrel too hard, but let's hope this one doesn't blow up on us. Don't necessarily like to take them all the way to round because we're going to do a lot of profiling here. So this is starting to look good, and let's give it a shape. We don't want to go too small on the base here because they need to be bottom heavy so they don't tip over. So I'm going to switch over to sanding here, probably readjust the camera. And actually, before I do the sanding, I'm going to put a little bit of a recess in the base, which is great. This mandrel, having this here, I can pull the tail support back and work on the base without it flying off or having to change a whole bunch of positions. So let's get that done. right, with the tail support out of the way, I can come in and refine the base a little bit, make it so it sits nice and level and it's got a little recess in it. Let's get that done. You want to go pretty slow here. Alright, that's looking good to my eye. Probably jump to a time lapse here, go through some sanding, go through the other two vases, and we'll come back and look at how they turned out. All right. Well, there they are. You know, the shape, kind of the sky's the limit. Have fun with it, play with it. I think what I go for is just three that don't quite look the same, but all look nice together. And I'm gonna add my test tubes. A nice little arrangement, great for small flowers. You could probably use them for a candle holder as well. But yeah, that's the project, and thanks for watching.